Okay, so I wanted to talk about this clip here, which I think can be instructional in both the macro sense and micro sense. I start off by making a big mistake, and then it kind of snowballs into more mistakes from my teammates. But then I'm able to bring it back with a great micro play and movement in the team fight. So if somebody dies, which it was me in this case, and I have to take responsibility for that huge mistake. You have to play defensively. You have to back off and wait for that guy to come back up to have the 5v5 again. So you have to just hold. Like you're not risking to fight anything. Because if you risk to fight stuff, you may end up dying, and then it's gonna be a 3v5, and then it's gonna be a 2v5, and then they just end the game. And with that said, I think the micro takeaway is that you can, by just the sheer threat of moving in and like back and forth and not like fully committing, just trying to pull skill shots and with good spacing, you can actually buy a lot of time and put a lot of pressure by just moving back and forth and trying to weaving in autos here and there and just pull people's cooldown. I think that's like a super underrated part. A lot of AD carries there, I think, they would just go in and either they kill everything or they just insta die, and you don't need to. You can go in and you can go out, you can go in and go out, and I eventually just weaved in back and forth enough times for me to basically buy time for my team to respawn, and then we could win the game. So I guess that is the theme of this clip. When people are dead in mid late game, you're essentially trying to buy time for them to come back up, because then you have a chance to really win the game. But that buying time aspect, people just really struggle with, I've noticed.